Hi, this is Garret, Biss. Thanks for checking out this video. Well, what I want to talk about in this video is overcoming that negative self-talk. So I've recently done some polls and I often ask people, what's the biggest struggle or the challenge that you face in recovery? And one thing that comes up all the time is that negative, that pesky, that annoying self-talk. And many people are looking for resources, they're looking for tools, they're looking for exercises that they can do to help deal with that negative self-talk. Something I've struggled with in my own life and struggled with in the past, and I found the greatest change and the greatest progress I've made in my recovery was finding ways to deal with and address this negative self-talk. So three things that I often share with people, very effective ways that we can deal with that, is one, start by giving ourselves credit where credit's due. So what do I mean by this? So we all the time, it's so easy to think of our failures. It's so easy to think of those mistakes that we've made. You know, people love to remind us of all the times that we've let them down or done something that we shouldn't do. And these things are always on our mind. They often come up. And there's a reason for this, which I'll share in a moment. But what we need to do is be conscious and take control and be responsible for reminding ourselves of some of the wins and some of the things that we've done well in our life. Because no matter who you are, no matter what age you are, no matter how long you've struggled or how long you've been in recovery, there's some incredible, wonderful, positive things that you've done in your life. But we need to make the effort to remind ourselves of that. So the first thing I recommend doing is just writing down and making a list of some different wins that you've had. You know, try to come up with 20 or 30 different things. And, you know, sometimes maybe you need to start small. Maybe you need to start with, you know, I learned how to walk. I learned how to read. I learned how to pass a spelling test in third grade. Whatever it is, start listing things that you've done. Because we need to remind ourselves of these things. Because if we don't, the only things that are going to keep replaying in our mind and the things that are keep coming up are all the failures that we've had and all the times, all the letdowns of all the mistakes that we've made. And there's a reason for this. So our mind is always looking for things that could potentially threaten us. And one place that this can happen is in those mistakes or in those failures or in those things that we've done in our past, because there's a direct correlation between those mistakes and our ability to survive, whether it's our ability to provide for ourselves so that we can continue to get the food and the shelter that we need for survival, or whether it's our ability to continue to be part of a tribe. You know, if we've hurt other people or we've failed other people in a way, then that can threaten our ability to have that connection and be part of a tribe, because the more that we do that, if we repeat that, it's going to threaten our ability to connect and be supported by other people, which we absolutely need. So our mind will continue to remind us of those mistakes that we've made and all these negative things that we've experienced or done in our life, and it sets aside all those positive things that we've done because they're no longer a threat to us. So we need to be conscious about and take that responsibility for reminding ourselves regularly of wins that we've had so that we at least have a voice contrasting or battling against those negative voices or thoughts that come up in our mind. Too often, if all we think about are those negatives, then we start to believe that that's all that we are, and we start to think of ourselves as somebody who's always going to fail, somebody who's always going to make mistakes, which is not true. And if you look back at some of the wins that you've had in your life, then you can see evidence to this. So very important thing, sit down, make a list of things, give yourself credit where credit is due so that you can remind yourself of this. And I like to keep a list of my wins somewhere nearby so I see it and I remember it quite often, because it gives me some ammunition to ward off those negative thoughts that come up that remind me of my failures and my losses. The next thing is recognize strengths. We all have strengths within us. There's a VIA character strengths test that identifies 34 different human strengths. And every human being has all of these strengths within them. It's just for the individual, some of these strengths might be more prominent than others. We all have, you know, about 5 defining strengths that define us, our character and our abilities. But we all have strengths within us. Too often when we're finding ourselves in recovery and looking at our past, we look at the faults that we have had, the mistakes that we've made. You know, the DSM, the Diagnostic Statistical Manual for Mental Health, recognizes, I don't know, 230, 300 or so defects that somebody can have. Well, defects are things that are negative to us. You know, whether you fall into one of those categories or not, you know, some of the diagnoses are kind of broad, and I'm sure that we all have some elements of many of them. Even whether we, you know, kind of cross that line, it could be diagnosed with one of them or not, there's certain things about us, certain negative things about us, tendencies, beliefs, behaviors that are negative to us, and they only pull us down or affect us in a negative direction. Well, if you look at the other side of it, the strengths that we have, we all do have certain inherent strengths in us. They're part of our character. They're part of our being. if we can remember those strengths that we have, and again, focus on those strengths, focus on the positive, then it can overcome a lot of that negative pull and that negative self-talk that's derived from thinking about and remembering those defects or those things that are wrong with us. So that can be a very important thing to do. I recommend looking at a list of 34 character strengths and identifying the ones that are most relevant to you or resonate most with you, and think about and remind yourself of those things the next time that negative voice comes up. The last thing that I help people do and that I recommend is looking at the positive of situations and events. A lot of times memories of things that we've done in the past will come up, and we'll think about all the negative that came from that. And too often we justify the negative consequences that we've experienced by thinking, you know, I deserve that because this voice in my head is telling me that I'm worthless, telling me that I'm stupid, telling me that I'm not good enough in some different way. So when we can identify positive things that came from past experiences, this can be a great way to overcome some of that negative self-talk. So even the mistakes that we've made, even some of those tough lessons that we've had to learn, there's something positive that came from that. Maybe it was a part of your rock bottom. Maybe some of those mistakes, some of those things that come up are a part of your rock bottom, but that's what you needed to change that tide and find yourself in recovery. So that's a positive thing that came from it. Sometimes we failed people or let people down or made mistakes in our life, but there's some negative consequence. That's what we think about, but there's also some positive things. There's also new strengths that came from that, new awareness, new wisdom, new drive, new motivation that came from some of our worst mistakes. And a lot of times we can take those negative things, we can take some of those negative consequences and overcome them and make sense of them and find value from those bad things that have happened in our life if we can derive some good from that. And I challenge you to think about some of those things. If this is stuff that comes up on your mind, I'm not asking you to go and revisit some mistakes that you've made if it's not something you constantly think about. But if it is something that you constantly think about, go back and look at some of the positives that came from that. You know, maybe you gained some new awareness. Maybe you gained some new strengths. Maybe something cost you a relationship or a job, but now you realize in hindsight that it was, you know, that was a good change in your life. Maybe that's the change that you needed to make at that time. Or maybe you just have greater awareness, greater compassion for other people going through. Now you have some experience that you can use to help people that face similar situations like that. So try to find some of those positives that come from that if you're constantly ruminating over those mistakes or over those negative experiences that you've had in your past. So give yourself credit where credit is due. Remember some of those wins, and it takes effort. Our brain's not going to continue to remind us of those wins, so you have to do it. So make a list. Think of some of the wins that you've had in your life. Identify and remind yourself of your strengths. You know, too often our mind likes to remind us of all of our weaknesses or all the things that we do wrong. Remind yourself of some of the strengths. And then lastly, look for the things that you've gained from some of those negative experiences. These are three very effective tools that can help you overcome some of that negative self-talk by not only addressing the voices and addressing those thoughts in your head, but addressing the source of some of that and identifying where some of that comes from and kind of cutting it off at the source or getting to the root to it. If you need more help with this, if you'd like some more explanation going through these exercises, I have created a free guide. You know, three powerful ways to overcome that negative self-talk, because what you deserve and what you should do and what we should get to is being able to love and accept ourselves just the way that we are. But beat that inner critic, you know, silence that inner critic, that negative self-talk in our mind, and really learn to love and accept ourselves as we are, because that's certainly what you deserve and certainly what's best for your recovery. But I've created a free guide. If you click in the link below right now, you can get it if you subscribe to the free video series, The First Steps to Thriving in Recovery. But I hope that helps. Please leave your comments in the video below. I'd love to hear what you think.